Welcome to the Electro-Voice headquarters in Minnesota. We're about to talk about an anechoic chamber. Come on in. You can see right away the difference in sound, because that's the whole purpose of this room. What is an anechoic chamber? It is a room with minimal to zero reflections in it. I'm going to shut the door. Not quite silent. You can still hear sound in an anechoic chamber. I know there's a lot of things going around the internet of, oh, you go into one of these things and you can hear the blood pumping through your veins. Maybe in other cases, but purpose of a room like this is in a practical sense, so you can really understand what the source sounds like in its purest form. You're not getting the rest of the reflections of the room, an airplane flying overhead. When we're taking measurements for how speakers are actually producing the sound of a guitar or a voice, you don't have anything else getting in the way. It's actually the pure tone from the thing. It's kind of as close as I get to being able to live inside of a DI box.
Yeah,
I can just plug my guitar in here and I get that. And we can take measurements of all those things and we can find what it is that I love about certain speakers and the way that they respond and accurately measure those and make decisions based on that. So here we have one of the engineers with EV, Mike, here to help us out, explain all this, because he did the math to build this room. And this is where he actually lives. His apartment is down here underneath. We're standing on a wire. Yes, let's acknowledge we are standing on
wire mesh floor.
Wire mesh floor, and that is part of the deal. Like, you know, a lot of people would think, oh, you could remove the reflections of a room by just going outside, but you got cement, you got grass. We have no floor, really, we're on. So tell us a little bit more about technically what's happening in this room and how you utilize it in your everyday life.
Great. Yeah, like you said, it's an anti-echo room, right? So, and just like you mentioned, why do we have an anti-echo room? When we design loudspeakers, when we do loudspeaker systems, we want to take really, really good measurements of those, and we want to design the loudspeaker, not the room that the loudspeaker is in, right? So having an environment like this, I can take the room out of that equation, and I can measure, equalize, and design just the loudspeaker and get that as perfect as possible.
So let me show you a quick example. Here's what it sounds like in this room. Hey, hey, check, check, one, two.
Hey, hey, check, check. Check, check, hey, hey. Check, check, hey, hey. Check, check, hey, hey. Hey, hey, check, check.
So you can hear, obviously, the room affects the way that the exact same source sounds and how it responds.
There's no reverb in this room, right? It's reverb time is zero.
Yes.
Right? So those other rooms are going to have some echoes, and that echo is going to last over time, create that reverberation. And all of that would be seen by the microphone that we use to measure the product. So when we go to do the design, we're not correcting things that are part of the room, not the speaker. That means that the speaker is going to work better in any room, and it's not designed for one specific scenario.
What kind of measurements are you testing?
Oh, we do a ton. I mean, everything from your frequency and impedance, but we also have a polar robot that we take all of our measurements on for propagation, for like the directivity data, right?
Sure.
Distortion, displacement, et cetera, et cetera. It goes on and on and on.
And historically, or those that don't have a chamber like this, they would take their tests, they would hear something, they'd make adjustments. Mm-hmm. But some of those adjustments might not be needed because they are hearing some of the room.
That's absolutely right.
So how do you construct a room like this, and how do you design it? You're not just putting random wedges in places and...
The wedges are... I mean, anechoic chamber was designed a very long time ago.
Yeah.
There's a couple companies that produced them. And the wedges are shaped the way they are to basically make it so that any audio wave that hits it kind of spreads out or diffracts out and then gets absorbed by the rest of the wedge. So you're creating a lot of surface area by making it a wedge.
Yeah.
And it gradually attenuates it, as opposed to having a large flat surface. If it was just a big solid piece of fiberglass, at some frequency you get a bounce off of
it,
right? So that was part of it. The fact that they change direction regularly is done on purpose, because again, you set up some pattern where you start getting some reflections.
Yeah.
Right? And then, so that is what keeps the sound that's created in the room from bouncing off the walls, but we also have to keep the sound from outside of the room from coming into the room as well.
Yeah.
And because you don't want to be blowing air around in this room, there's no HVAC, there's no heating and cooling, right?
Yeah.
So what we do to try to keep it, you know, reasonably temperate in here is have the wedges are mounted to a wall, and then there's a foot of airspace, and then there's another wall on the outside of that, and the whole building is just suspended all the way around, isolated from the rest of our building and our labs.
Yeah.
And that way we can keep as much of the noise that you get outside if you're trying to do outside measurements, you know, trucks driving by, planes going overhead, birds squawking and we can get really low noise floors, which you mentioned earlier we don't really need because we make really loud product.
Yeah.
So we get really good signal noise ratios, right?
Yeah.
Which is what we truly care about. In the end, we have a room that does a really great job at keeping the sounds out, keeping the sounds that we want directly measured, direct, and all the reverberant and reflected sounds dampened, gone.
It's a lot of work to do something, but when you care that much about something, you know, why wouldn't you just figure out how to do it? And that's what's wonderful here at EV. Everything goes through this room. All the speakers get tested here, and you just get something that's much more consistent than if it was tested in a room with reflections. So yes, not everybody has one of these rooms at their disposal. It is a true treat to be able to be here. EV is kind enough to let us come in here every once in a while, and it's really fun. But if you get a chance to, I would suggest trying to find one of these types of rooms, which, like Mike said, they're pretty rare. But this is a really interesting room because, seriously, it feels like you're in a DI box. There's just no reflection. It is just the tightest, driest sounding room I've ever, and very quiet room I've been in maybe in my entire life. So it's pretty cool. Would be a very interesting place to do a concert.
I think so too.
Well, we'll maybe have to test it out. But yeah. Thanks for hanging with us. We'll see you next time. Peace.
See ya.